Over the last years, TPath have become a very useful Swift syntax, mostly because very popular frameworks like SwiftUI or Combine have designed their APIs to work with KeyPaths. But do you think you know all the possibilities offered by a KeyPath? In this video, I'm going to show you 5 things you probably didn't know about KeyPaths. Let's start with number 1. Whenever you use a method like map or filter, you can pass it a KeyPath instead of a closure. And the compiler will actually take care of translating that KeyPath to a closure. Moving on to number 2, did you know there's actually more than one type of KeyPath? The classic KeyPath type is actually a reference to a read-only property. When we take a KeyPath to a writable property, we get a writable KeyPath. And when working with a reference type, we even get a reference writable KeyPath. Most of the time, we don't need to care about these different types as the compiler will map a literal KeyPath to the correct type. However, if we write our own APIs, then these differences become important because we'll need to use the correct type depending on what we want to do with the KeyPath. And there are even a few more types to deal with type erasure. Let's move on to number 3. We are all familiar with KeyPaths that reference properties, but did you know that a KeyPath can also reference a subscript? Here, for instance, I'm taking a KeyPath to the property name of the second element in an array of person. From there, we can simply invoke that KeyPath over the array, just like we would with a single value. Now for number 4, let's talk about how we can use KeyPath to write nice little DSLs like this type safe predicate syntax. To make this syntax work in Swift, we actually only need to implement a single function. We just need to implement an overload of the operator greater than that takes as its left-hand side a KeyPath, as its right-hand side a constant, and then use the KeyPath to compare the value of the property to that of the constant. Finally, for number 5, did you know we can use dynamic member lookup with a KeyPath? Consider the struct order I've just declared. I would like to be able to access the properties of the address directly on the struct itself. To do so, we start by annotating the struct with @dynamic_member_lookup. Then we implement a subscript that takes as its argument a KeyPath to a property of an address, and we invoke that KeyPath on the property address. And that's it. We can now directly access the properties of the address. Since our implementation of the subscript relies on a KeyPath, this syntax is type safe, meaning that if we try to call a property that doesn't exist on an address, it will result in a compilation error. And that's it. These were the 5 things you probably didn't know about KeyPaths. If you've enjoyed this new format, please let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching and see you next time.